Ebenezer Me. Information for transformation.
I'm going to speak to you for a few minutes. As you know, today is the prayer meeting day, and the Lord has promised to move in an awesome manner. I know there is someone here today that beginning from now, the power that has made you cry shall be buried alive. I'm speaking to you for a few minutes on what I call my story has changed. Can you say that loud and clear? Can you turn to seven verses? Seven verses. My saints. Amen. Now, there are seven facts that I want you to know about divine operations. Seven facts that I want you to know about divine operations. The first fact, you may believe it, you may not believe it, but it is a hard fact, is that there is no problem too hard for God to solve. That's the first fact. What did I say just now? That's the first fact about divine operations you should know. The second fact you should know about divine operations is that in the dictionary of the Almighty, the word impossibility does not exist. Because it says, with man, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. The third fact about divine operation I want you to know is this. Sister, hear me well. Brothers, this is clear and clear. When God appears at your battlefront, that's the end of the battle. When God appears at the battlefront, there is no battle again. That's the end of the battle. The battle may rage for a long time, but the day God arises, that is it. And when he arises, whether you believe or you don't believe, once he's there, that's the end of the battle. I see someone here today, that God will arise at the battlefront, and there will be no battle again. If you are that person, shout it loud, hallelujah. The fourth fact about divine operation that I want you to understand and to know, no matter the strength of your opposition, one word from the master will scatter them. No matter the strength of your opposition, one word from the Lord will scatter them. The fifth fact that I want you to know about divine operations is that there is no situation in any life now that God has not resolved before. There is no new case. No new case before God. Like the Bible said, there is nothing new under the sun. There is no situation in life now that God has not resolved before. Those who regularly attend prayer in will remember the day when that 54-year-old woman was giving testimony about childbirth. After 30-something years. With God, all things are possible. The sixth fact, if you know, is this. When men have come to their wit's end, that is the beginning of divine operations. When you have tried and then you have raised the full stop back, is then God opens his own sentence and begins to move. Seventh fact about divine operation is that God is a story changer. God is a story changer. In Mark chapter 5, I read from verse 2. Mark chapter 5, I read from verse 2. Mark chapter 5, from verse 2. Are we there? And when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwellings among the tombs, and no man could bind him. No, not with chains. Because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broken in pieces, neither could any man tame him. And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying and cutting himself with chains. But when he saw Jesus afar off. He ran
and worshipped him.
He ran
and worshipped him.
Beloved, this is the story of one man.
Is this your story?
Crying always night and day.
Is this your story?
Scavenging the tombs.
Is this your story?
Bound by visible and invisible chains.
Is this your story?
That the situation has become so wild that no man can help. No mortal chains can help. No summons can help. No deliverance can help. No father's discipline can help. No family discipline, no family appeal has been able to help.
Is this your story?
Is this your story?
A living dead with your home among the dead.
Is this your story?
That you are strangely at home with society's dead and decaying cast out.
Is this your story?
That you are completely seduced by the devil.
Is this your story?
That you are even taking actions and you are harming yourself.
You are harming yourself. You are harming yourself is your pastime.
Is this your story?
That you are batting yourself with stones as if you have been dropped into instrumental destruction.
Is this your story?
That you are going on a path of destruction and you are running fast on that track.
Is this your story?
You've been forgotten by friends and abandoned by family members like this man here.
Is this your story?
You are lonely, are depressed, and abandoned.
Is this your story?
That demons seem to overcome you with ease.
Is this your story?
That you are feeding from the dining table of darkness.
Is this your story?
That everybody seems to have given up on you.
Is this your story?
That any time you try to smile, it's crying that comes out.
Is this your story?
All your efforts have been frustrated.
Is this your story?
You've prayed, done deliverance, done all kinds of things, but no way.
Is this your story?
That those who should help you are turning against you.
Is this your story?
When you are supposed to be on ladder, the round of the ladder number 10, you are number 1.
If
that is so, listen to me really hard, because I got information from heaven for you today.
If that is your story, beloved, you shall see Jesus today. In the name of Jesus, then your story shall change through the encounter with the Son of God. In the name of Jesus, then every bondage to death in the graveyard of life shall be broken today in the name of Jesus. Then every chain fabricated by witchcraft, fabricated by sorcery against you shall be shattered today. And then you shall meet the master. 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 In the name of Jesus.
Look at Mark chapter 5, verse 15. And they come to Jesus and see him that was possessed with the devil. It has become past tense now. The story has changed.
And they came to Jesus and saw him that was possessed with the devil, that had the legion,
sitting and cool in his right mind.
And they were afraid.
I speak by the authority of heaven and by the decree in the word of God, that either the enemy likes it or not, a story shall check, a story shall check, a story shall check, my strength shall check, a story shall check, a story shall check, in the name of Jesus. And Jesus shall make you a testimony. He shall make you a wonder. He shall make you a marvel. And you who used to cry out from the torments of the devil shall now begin to cry out in the name of the Lord. And you shall be restored to your right mind. You shall be restored to your home again. He stood as Satan legion have forced me into the wilderness of the graveyard.
It is true that house of wickedness and paths of witchcraft have pushed you into the graveyard of life.
But it is also true that you are coming out.
Where you are,
and is coming your way. The master says you have cried enough.
Listen carefully. That graveyard experience is the devil's plot to waste your life.
But it is merely a comma, a pause. It is not the end. It is merely a comma in a sentence. it is not your full stop. You shall yet be for testimony. Then your past, having instantly become past tense, as that man would rather that him that was possessed, then your God will now arise and make you a priest. But then, when the master comes away, don't refuse it. Like the man in our story, like the man in that story, he had a determination and a decision. He was applying your action in your decision in spite of the graveyard intimidation that is surrounding us. You have to run to Jesus the way that man ran to Jesus. Today is that day when your story must change. There is nothing too hard for the Lord. There is no promise too hard for the Lord to fulfill. There is no prayer too hard for God to answer. There is no enemy too hard for God to dismantle. There is no mountain too hard for God to climb. There is no reproach too stubborn for God to remove. But there is a small mistake we all make. And that great mistake is this. The great mistake is to verbalize your doubt. When you verbalize your doubt, faith will jump out. And that terrible thing that you said will come to pass. The Spirit of God came upon Elijah and he gave what you can call a mad prophecy. So mad that it's something like this. Is that all of a sudden there is no food in this Lagos. And one prophet came. I said, that's the end of the Lord. By tomorrow, a bag of garri can be 50 kobo. That's what he said. That is as mad as that. There was a man that had it. And he said, this God is who will open the window of heaven. This is another zone. That man made a mistake. He verbalized his doubt. And he got an evil prophecy. Look at it with your eyes, you will see it. And you will not take part of it. Zechariah would have lost his miracle if not for the quick action of that angel who quickly made him dumb, unable to speak. Because when the angel came, and the I am Gabriel that stands by the altar of God, and I've been sent to give you information, and behold, your wife Elizabeth shall conceive, and shall bear a son, and shall call his name John. Many shall rejoice at his birth, for he shall go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah, shall turn the hearts of the fathers and the children. And the angel gave him these powerful prophecies. The man looked at him and shook his head. The angel, if you have better information, better give it. Because my wife is old and I'm advanced in age, so it's not possible. And the angel said, look, I am Gabriel that stands by the throne of God. Because you do not believe my word, you shall be fulfilled in their season. You shall be dumb and unable to speak until the child comes. Why did the angel close his mouth? Because if the client began to talk, the doubt was talking, there would be no miracle. A lot of us puncture our miracle by entertaining thoughts of failure, by meditating on the magnitude of the problem as described by whoever. We puncture our miracle when we begin to discouragement, when we begin to listen to the symptoms of the sickness, when we begin to try other solutions apart from God and prayers. We puncture our miracle when we are entertaining the thoughts of giving up and committing suicide. We puncture our miracles by negative confessions, by verbalizing our doubts. Noah's generation perished. Why? They refused to believe. Peter sank because he doubted. Zechariah became dumb because he refused to believe. The disciples got so confused after the death of Jesus because they did not believe. That Israeli ruler in Samaria died because of unbelief. Those 10 spies that Moses sent, they died because of unbelief. God may delay, but God does not deny. There is a difference between unanswered prayer and ungranted prayer. It is interesting to note that as many people as are in the Bible and they verbalized their doubt, they got into trouble. When the 10 spies came back, so we saw them, they are giants. They are grasshoppers. They cannot fight them. God came. I said, okay, since you have said you are grasshoppers, so shall you be. Bow down your head. Tell the Lord to forgive you. In areas where you have punctured your own miracle and verbalized your doubt and given the enemy a room to begin to move against your life, ask Him to forgive you. Ask Him to forgive you because your story must change. If they have called you a bad name before,
That name must be changed now. If you have given you an evil description before, that evil description must be cancelled. If you have been oppressed before, your story must change to the one who oppresses the oppressor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Rise up on your feet now. And listen to me very carefully. The Bible says, if that covenant to God must believe that He is, and is a rewarder of them that diligently seek, without faith, it is impossible to please God. We have plenty of prayers to pray this morning. Each prayer has an agenda. Each prayer has a purpose. Each prayer has thousands of breakthroughs attached to it. Each prayer will only be prayed for a short time. So meaning that you cannot afford to keep quiet. When I want you to sit down, I want you to sit down. Now it's time to stand. As you are going to start praying now, the first thing that will start happening immediately, that the angels of God will go right into the midst and begin to operate on people's eyes. Eyes that have been attacked by witchcraft powers and powers of darkness. Those angels will begin to operate in the chest area. Those that the enemy is blocking their breathing and their hearts. Powers will begin to jump out from those areas. Some angels will begin to carry out operations on the stomach, operations in the womb, operations at the backbone. As the prayers are going on, the powers of paralysis shall be broken to pieces. And then, a repair shall begin to take place. God is so afraid. Say this after me. Oh God! And stay the wind to bring my restoration. Can you set up and let me hear you? Jesus, let him begin to scare the winds. Let him scare the wind in the name of Jesus. Marebosso, Marabocoso Pondeke. In Jesus' name we pray. Promote me in the name of Jesus. New patterns in my life that will promote it. I will pray this prayer, beloved. New patterns, now the old patterns are broken away. In Jesus' name we pray. Every evil wind blowing against me. Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. Something is happening over there. Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus' name we pray. That's that the Lord is doing a surgical operation in the ear of somebody, and somebody's ear has just vanished completely. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Look at that arrow of infirmity. Fired into every area of the body. It's been shaken out. That's right. Thank you, Jesus. You that woman, that you are having this strange movement underneath your hand, and you have been smelling death. Right away, you have the power of God is coming upon you. And the yoke of that strange creature under your skin. Broken to pieces. Yes. Shall we slow down here? Affliction! Kill the officials. Yes. Masoto kate kapo ya bo shenta. Riba kapo na kasa ya ba. Manaka Rabo Sopunda Kayabo Shantaraba. Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Silence, beloved. Someone has been passing uncontrollable urine. The power of God is coming upon you. That's right. Thank you, Jesus. The virtues collected from somebody in the dream is being returned back to you. Yes, something is coming out of somebody over there. The thing is like a long rope being pulled out from the right leg. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. While someone here is like you are hearing sounds of gunshots in your ears, these are powers assigned to eliminate your life. Right there where you are, the power of God is coming upon you too. The yoke of those killing powers is broken completely. In the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Aha, 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 aha. In Jesus' name we pray. Something strange is happening down there. There are three personalities walking out of somebody. That's right. Someone is here, doctors have cut off somewhere in your body. Right there where you are, you can feel the heat in that part of the body. And a new organ has been put back into position. Yes.
Send the girl loud and clear. Blood of Jesus! Between me and every strange altar, in the name of Jesus, stand between me and every strange altar, so that the altar will not affect my life. In the name of Jesus, Master Kaya Boshendera Basanda. Jesus' name we pray. Say, blood of Jesus, secure my passion, secure my destiny. In the name of Jesus. Aha, aha. Yes, yes. Continue to speak it out. Continue to speak it out. Masukaya Boshendera Bakaraba. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, blood of Jesus, I want to believe you are praying. So you have very short time for this prayer. But things are happening all over this place. Blood of Jesus! One, three times. Look at what is happening right now. One power that has been squeezing the womb of one woman together is releasing that womb now. Releasing the womb now. Releasing the womb now. That's right. Now, if that person with terrible pain at the back of your head and the bone at the back of your head, shake it now to find out the healing power that has come upon that backbone. Thank you, Jesus. Something has just been taken out from somebody's body. You came here with it. But check it now. It has been taken away back to the senders. You pray this one three times. Blood of Jesus. Separate me from the iniquities of other men. Meaning that you will not suffer for what somebody else has done. Separate me from the iniquities of other men. Blood of Jesus. Name we pray. Open your mouth and pray to me. Mashitaribuko soponte. Nariboko soponte keya boshente raba. Nariboko soponte keya ba. Jesus' name we pray. This is the third time. Open your mouth and pray. Separate me. Masekaya Boshenta Rabakaraba Santa. Aha, aha. In Jesus' name we pray. One arm on the head, one arm on the chest.
and speak loud and clear like this.
Every hour of darkness in my body,
every word of the Lord, can I hear you shouting this loud and clear? I'm sure you can shout it louder than that. Make it louder than that, beloved. In the name of Jesus, in the house today. Yes, 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 yes. Thank you, Jesus. You may put your hand down now. Now check your body thoroughly. You know that the power of God has touched your body. And you came here with something and it's no longer there. Don't allow the devil to put it back on you. Just find a way to the altar here. So you can pray with you to retain that miracle. Just find a way to the altar here. So you can pray for you to retain that which the Lord has done in your life. Now you will say this louder than anyone here. Please don't joke with this prayer. Please pray it with anger. Struggle of witchcraft against me. If I were that sister from Cross River Danga, I will shout it louder than anyone here. Struggle of witchcraft against me. In the name of Jesus. Yes. As someone who came to this service is a satanic migraine. I think the enemy wants to blow up your head. The 7 hours fired into that head, they're being taken out one by one. There are some firstborns here this morning, which the enemy has been using as a foot mask. But this morning, they have been delivered by the power of God. That person here, that they say the baby in your womb is dead. Right away, you are, the power of God is coming upon you. And the resurrection power of God is coming upon that baby. Yes, that's the power of God. Thank you, Jesus. Say this loud and clear. Every bad luck transferred into my life. Can you shout it loud and clear? Command the bad luck to come out. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As a sister here, this strange woman from your husband has planted an infirmity in your body, and the infirmity is coming out now. That's right. Yes, receive your healing from that cancer, from the kidney trouble, from the heart disease, from the diabetes, from the sleeplessness. Aha. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Jesus.
Stand with us, boiling anger. Every power! Opening the gates of my life to darkness. Yeah! In the name of Jesus. Yes. 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 Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Something is taking place over there. Yes. The evil swelling inside the body, inside the breast, is being taken out. Check it now. That's right. The under the oppressor that has been producing fire inside your body has been shaken out from your body now. Thank you, Jesus. Aha. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Say this loud and clear. Healing arrows in my body. We are in the name of Jesus. Command healing arrows of Judah. Wida! In Jesus' name we pray.
Check your body again now, beloved. You came here with a particular condition and it has just vanished. Find a way to do something very quickly. So you can pray with you and put a seal on that testimony. Is seen on that miracle. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The enemy has taken something away from one man over there. Right there, the Holy Ghost is returning what the enemy has stolen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Shout this louder than anyone around you. Make sure nobody's voice overshadows your home. Ensure that if you notice that somebody's voice is going to overshadow your home, make it louder.
Oh God! As a crab-like object moving out of the body of a sister over there. This is the object that has been pushing out your babies and causing miscarriages. The power of God is coming upon you there.
Yes.
This is the final time I want you to read that prayer. Oh God! Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Receive the touch of the power of God. 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 Receive the touch of the power. 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 The story is changing, the story is changing. The story is changing. By the power of the universe. By the power of the universe. By the power of others. Oh God of us. And let my story change. Let my story change. Let my story change. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, name you pray.
Thanks for watching. Remember to click the subscribe button and the notification bell beside it to be updated with Ebenezer Meek channel's video whenever available. Don't forget to comment, like, and share the video with your friends and family. Bye.